The whole show is my pet peeves, by the way. I swear to God, this Asian dude's gonna leave and be like, Raven Simone was so angry, I don't get it. Oh, that is not so Raven. Why she's so angry? Oh man, I didn't realize as a parent, especially of babies, you need so much equipment. It's like a walking Shark Tank episode. I'm like, what is this? I can't remember the names for everything. I'm tired. And one day I was taking baby girl out for a walk and I forgot the name of the Bjorn. So I just yelled in the house. I said, baby, give me the strap on for our daughter. I'm a good person. I'm a good mom. Oh my God. And also, I didn't realize you have to become like a low budget Dr. Oz right away. Like these little bodies, something goes wrong. It's just like, how do I fix this? You know, like I've never even bathed a baby before. And oh my God, I'll just tell you this right now. They slippery as fuck. But they're resilient. It's all cartilage, so. I'll never forget the first time we gave the babies a bath. It was warm water, really cute organic soap. I said, it's gonna be great. We put them in the water. They were crying like it was battery acid. I said, get them out the water. We're never gonna bathe them. My husband's like, we gotta bathe them. I said, no, we don't. We're just gonna get the hot spots like a walk of shame. Thank you, white girls be snapping. I love woke white people. Yes, this is my town hall. Thank you so much. Yes, let's get to the issues at hand. I love her. Cute little white girl in the back. Yes, sister. Yes, sis. Speak on it, sis. I'll see you on TikTok.
Also, guys, don't take your dick out. Who's taking their dick out? Nobody wanna see your dick. Nobody wanna see your dick. You know somebody wants to see your dick if they say, let me see your dick. I wanna see that dick. That's how you know somebody wants to see your dick, guys. Come on. Matt Lauer, nobody wants to see your crusty bit of dick. Yuck. Louis C.K., nobody wants to see that ginger dick. No, thank you. Harvey Weinstein, nobody wants to see that pastrami mess. Yuck. Charlie Rose, how did he get his adult diaper off to show his dick? I don't know.
I'm doing really well. Very exciting time for me. I just turned 40. What? I know, thank you so much. I don't look 40 at all because I'm happy. And I'll take it, I'll take it. My friends are like, girl, shit's gonna change when you turn 40, you just see. And I'm like, shut up, what are you talking about? But like a light switch, it changed. Like, the minute I turned 40, I was like, ooh, I am all about comfort. I have to be comfortable all the time. Like, I can't wear anything with buttons. Uh-uh, not with these tig old bitties. Are you serious? And the right breast is bigger, so it's always trying to come out. I call it John McCain. It's like a POW. I was just in the San Francisco airport. They had a breastfeeding room. Ooh, I just went in there and took my bra off for 2 hours. I'm all about that comfort. This lady was like, do you have a baby? I'm like, mind your business, bitch. I'm freeing my nipple, I'm 40.
This is something that happens in your 40s that nobody tells you. You think about how you're gonna fall. You think about how you're gonna fall. I said, girl, how you gonna fall? I said, I don't know, girl. I said, girl, we gonna fall on our face? And I'm like, no, girl. You gonna chip your tooth. And a chip tooth, freckles, and big titties? That's too much character. We don't need all that character. I go out on a lot of big Hollywood auditions, y'all. Ooh, real big stuff. Real big Hollywood stuff. Most of the characters I go in for, they're described as tired, mom, real looking body, just lost a bunch of weight. That's my look. The favorite thing that, like, my most favorite thing that I go in for, oh my God, this is so juicy, is called open ethnicity. The fuck is that? Open ethnicity? Think about that. How open are we talking right now with this ethnicity? Also, isn't open ethnicity just human? I go to these auditions, open ethnicity auditions. It's Indian girls, Chinese girls, Spanish girls, black girls. I'm like, oh, this is just a politically correct way of saying everybody white and you get to be the ethnic neighbor. Let's find out what neighborhood we're gonna be in. And they'll never be like, we're looking for a black girl, African-American. They'll just say shit like, looking for someone who's sassy, real confident, can tell it like it is, doesn't want to get her hair wet in the hot tub. What? How the fuck they know? I also realized at 40, I cannot fake the funk anymore. Like, I used to be so good at small talk, like it was my jam. You know what I mean? I see someone, I'd be like, oh my God, girl, those earrings, yes. Are those Etsy? What, you made them? Oh my God, girl, yeah, fuck her. I don't care. I am so transparent right now. I don't care. I feel like it's too obvious, though. I feel like Steve Harvey Family Feud obvious. You know what I'm talking about? He is always happier to see the black families than he is the white families. What? He's like, we got the McLaughlins and we got the Joneses! I hurt my neck. 40. I also realized at 40, I got too many friends. Why do I know all these dummies? I feel like a friend hoarder. They're just collecting dust. I feel like I'm running a soup kitchen. These bitches come over with Tupperware and blankets. I'm like, what you doing? My husband was like, babe, why you know so many people? Stop knowing so many people. Can you stop making eye contact? I'm like, I'll try. But I had to take a deep dive and really think about, why do I know all these people? And real talk, I think it's because I want a dope-ass funeral. I do. I want it like standing room only, a hashtag, maybe a dance mob breaks out. I want it to be multicultural. I want it to look like the audience for Hamilton the musical. You know what I mean? I might even have a destination funeral. I don't know. You might want to know me, bitch. And I don't know. You guys have a type, right? But you don't even realize that you are somebody else's type. Hello from the other side.
Whoever.
Yes, honey, you are somebody else's type. You don't even know that. Like, I realized way too late in life that I am an achievable Beyonce for government workers. Named Lawrence, Dennis, Curtis, Otis, anything in the East, they love me. Ooh! I can't go to a Veterans Day parade. My booty ain't safe. She is not safe. They looking at me like they want me to motorboat the PTSD off their face, and I'll do it because I'm a patriot. Thank you so much. Ooh, thoughts and prayers. Thank you for your service. Thank you so much. I mean, I don't know about you, but I can make a government worker work a holiday. That's power, bitch. What you do. I'm just saying, you want to go to the post office with me in December, okay? You know, you do have to do what your partner likes to do. And when you're like different nationalities and different countries, it's just hard sometimes. Like, I'm with a white boy, yes. So I understand I'm have to do some white boy shit. But European white boy is next level white boy shit. Real talk. Like, the other day, we were home, I was working. He's like, babe, come meet me outside. I said, let me put my shoes on. Hold up. He's like, you don't need your shoes. I said, yes, I do. And you do too. I go meet him outside. He's like, put your phone away. I said, let me drop this pen first. I don't know what activity this is. This is new. He's like, give me your hands. I was like, ah, is this a rose ceremony? This ain't cute. And he goes, let's look at the sun. And let's try to guess what time it is. I said, motherfucker, I got a job. But sometimes I feel like I just don't understand him, right? Like, I'm his, like, sassy American wife, and he's this very polite white Dutch dude. And I don't understand him sometimes. And I feel like he doesn't understand the nuance of an American husband. You know, I'm from Jersey, and he thinks I sound aggressive all the time. That's his thing. Like, I'll be making breakfast, and I swear to God, I feel like he just hears DMX, you know? For real. I'm like, how you want your eggs? How you want your eggs? This your way? The day before the election, November 7th, 2016, I had a big to-do list because I didn't know who was going to win the next day. I didn't know what was going to happen with my health care. So I was like, let me get all the holes checked because I am too cute for bacteria. So I made an appointment for a pap smear. Yes, a pap smear. I go with bagels and lox and thinly sliced red onions, capers. And I'm not into fashion advice, but ladies, I will say this, do not wear a onesie or a romper to your pap smear because you will be the creepy naked girl at the office. And I'm a good person, I'm a good host. I know it's an awkward situation. I like to have a good rapport with my doctor. He's so old, I don't know if he can hear me half the time. You know, he's not like Idris Elba or George Clooney. He sort of looked like Bernie Sanders with scoliosis. And I don't know what kind of day he's had, but when he's with me, I put scented lotion on my feet so he gets notes of vanilla from Victoria's Secret. And half the time he can't even find the hole. I'm like, get in there, doctor, get in! I call it the Holland Tunnel because he knows my husband's Dutch. What? Yes, honey, we have jokes. Gas is cheaper on the other side. Hello? That's a joke about Jersey and my asshole. Keep up. The hardest part of working with J-Lo is pretending that I didn't know everything about her. I know everything about J-Lo. For example, I know that we have the same birthday. Yes, July 24th. But I didn't want to tell her the first day because you can't. I don't want to be the creepy girl on the set, you know what I mean? But there's always somebody at the office that's into astrology. You know who you are. Always worried about the sun and the moon, never get taxes. So we had one of those assholes on set. I said, okay, I'm gonna wait for my moment. And sure enough, 3 weeks later, he goes, ah, you and Jen have the same face because you're both Leos. I said, oh, this is my moment. So I said, Jen, you a Leo? She said, stop. I said, I will not. That's so crazy. I said, Jen, when's your birthday? Yo, I was so good at this. Meryl Streep would be like, give that bitch the Oscar, okay? Just give that bitch the Oscar. So I said, Jen, my birthday is July 24th. What? She said, no. I said, yes. She said, your birthday July 24th? I said, isn't that crazy? She said, no one has my birthday. I said, I know, it's so special. I said, Jen, we should have a joint birthday party. And then she walked away, didn't talk to me for like 3 hours.